Continuation to importance of organometallic compounds in organic synthesis. Today we will learn organosulfur compounds. So sulfur containing organic compounds are known as organosulfur compounds. Cysteine and methionine are the naturally occurring organosulfur compound containing amino acids. So naturally occurring amino acids, cysteine and methionine, are the very good example for organosulfur compound which contain sulfur atom. So this is cysteine and methionine. Among the organosulfur compounds, thioethers as well as thiols and their derivatives are the most important organosulfur compounds which has wide application in organic synthesis. So if you come for the preparation, how this thiols and thioethers are prepared is, thiols can be prepared from alkylates. So it is a simple reaction of alkylate with sodium hydrosulfide will give corresponding thiols. So alkylate upon reaction with sodium hydrosulfide in presence of thermal condition, it is going to form corresponding thiol derivative. So that is from alkyl halide. So thiols also be prepared from alcohols. So reaction of alcohol with hydrogen sulfide in presence of thorium oxide as catalyst under thermal condition leads to the formation of thiols. So alcohols upon treatment with hydrogen sulfide in presence of thorium oxide under thermal condition lead to the formation of thiol. So this is preparation of thiols. So if you come for thioethers, how thioethers are prepared? So thioethers can be prepared from alkyl halides. So here the reaction of two equivalents of alkyl halide with potassium sulfide yields thioethers. So two equivalents of alkyl halides upon treatment with potassium sulfide under thermal condition will lead to the formation of corresponding thioethers. So other method is same, the substrate is alkyl halide, but upon treatment with sodium salt of thiols. So whatever the methods we have seen for the preparation of thiols, so from that thiol, if you take sodium salt of thiol, if it is reacted with alkyl halide under thermal condition, it is going to lead to the formation of thioethers. So these are the methods of preparation of thioethers and thiols. So if you come for the reactions of this thiols and thioethers are nucleophilic substitution reactions. So thioethers undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction with alkyl halide to form sulfonium salt. So thioether will undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction with alkyl halide. So and it is going to form sulfonium salts. And this sulfonium salts are very important reagent which is used in the organic synthesis. So in the later section of this lecture, we will see the importance of this sulfonium salts. And this thioethers also undergo mild oxidation in presence of hydrogen peroxide or metachloroperbenzoic acid to give dimethyl sulfoxide. So if the dimethyl sulfoxide further it is treated with oxidizing agent like H2O2 or metachloroperbenzoic acid, it will undergo further oxidation, leads to the formation of sulfur. So this sulfoxide, sulfone, as well as sulfonium salt, they are very important reagent or intermediate for the organic synthesis. So dimethyl sulfoxide undergo deprotonation reaction in presence of sodium hydride to form dimethyl anion, which is going to act as nucleophile and also act as strong base for preparation of sulfur. So whatever the dimethyl or sulfoxide we have got in the previous reaction by oxidation of thioether, it will undergo deprotonation reaction in presence of strong base and it is going to form anion. This anion is going to act as nucleophile as well as strong base. And this dimethyl sulfoxide will also undergo addition reaction. So dimethyl sulfoxide undergo alkylation reaction with alkyl halide to form sulfoxonium salt. So this dimethyl sulfoxide obtained by the oxidation of thioether will undergo addition reaction with alkyl halide like methyl iodide, and it is going to form sulfoxonium salt. And this sulfoxonium salt is also a very important reagent in the organic synthesis. Now, this sulfonium and sulfoxonium salt undergo deprotonation reaction with strong base like dimethyl anion to form sulfur halides. And these sulfur halides are stabilized by bonding with sulfur 3D orbital. So, whatever the sulfonium salt we have got by nucleophilic substitution reaction of dimethyl sulfide with alkyl halides and as well as with sulfoxonium salt, if they are treated with dimethyl anion. So, whatever the dimethyl anion we got from the deprotonation reaction, so we have mentioned it is going to act as nucleophile as well as a strong base. So, this dimethyl anion, now it is going to act as a strong base. So, it is going to abstract a proton from this sulfonium salt and it is going to form an important intermediate, that is sulfur halide. And these sulfur halides are stable because they are going to bond with sulfur 3D orbital. So, they are stable, and these sulfur halides are very, very important in organic synthesis. Same case, sulfoxonium salt upon treatment with dimethyl anion, it is going to abstract proton and it is going to form a stabilized sulfoxonium salt. Next, the sulfur halides react with aldehyde or ketone to form sulfur containing adducts. So, whatever the sulfur halides we have got in the previous reaction by deprotonation, it will undergo addition reaction with aldehydes and ketone and it is going to form an adduct containing sulfur. So, this is the adduct which is formed by the addition of this sulfur halide to the carbonyl carbon of aldehyde or ketone. So, this sulfur containing adduct undergoes intramolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction to give an epoxide. So, this sulfur halide is going to form sulfur containing adduct. So, this sulfur containing adduct will undergo intramolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction to give epoxide. So, which is very similar to phosphorus halide. So, in the case of phosphorus halide, we have got alkene. So, here in the case of sulfur halide, we are not going to get alkene. Instead, we are going to get epoxide. So, this is the importance of sulfur halide. And this sulfur halide is an unstabilized sulfur halide. So, if we take stabilized sulfur halide, so this sulfur halide, it is stabilized because there is a resonance stabilization by this oxo group present on the sulfur. So, it is a stabilized sulfur halide and it is called sulfoxonium sulfur halide or sulfoxonium will undergo addition reaction with the cyclohexanone. It is going to form sulfur containing adduct, and this sulfur containing adduct will undergo intramolecular substitution reaction to give corresponding epoxide derivative. So, this is important reaction of sulfur halide with aldehydes and ketone. If sulfur halides treated with aldehyde or ketone, they will undergo addition reaction to form an adduct product which contains sulfur, and that sulfur containing adduct product will undergo intramolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction to form epoxide. So, here it is just conversion of aldehyde or ketone to corresponding epoxide will be carried out. So, what happens if unsaturated carbonyl compounds, unstabilized sulfur halide gives epoxide whereas stabilized sulfur elate gives cyclopropane derivatives. So this is the difference between unsaturated carbonyl compound and saturated carbonyl compound. So if there is no unsaturation in the alpha beta unsaturated, both stabilized and unstabilized sulfur elate will give epoxide derivative. But if there is any stabilized sulfur elate, gives cyclopropane derivatives. So this is the example, alpha beta unsaturated cyclohexanone. Upon treatment with unstabilized sulfur elate, it is going to form epoxide derivative. So whereas this cyclohexanone, upon treatment with stabilized sulfur elate, now instead of epoxide, it is going to form cyclopropane derivative. So this is the important difference. So if there is no unsaturation, or if there is no M type of group adjacent to carbonyl group, then both stabilized and unstabilized sulfur elate will give epoxide. If there is a double bond adjacent to minus M type of group, that is carbonyl group, then unstabilized sulfur elate will give epoxide, whereas stabilized sulfur elate will give cyclopropane derivative. And if you come for the reactions of disulfides, so dimethyl or diphenyl disulfides in presence of base reacts with compound containing activated CH bond, followed by oxidation results in sulfoxide. So if you have a activated methylene group, then it is treated with the base, it is going to form anion. So this anion derivative, if it reacts, if there is a presence of diphenyl or dimethyl disulfide, then it will undergo a substitution reaction to form corresponding sulfur containing adduct. So this sulfur containing adduct will undergo oxidation to form sulfoxide derivative. So this sulfoxide derivative finally undergoes elimination on heating to give double bond. So here this method can be used for the introduction of double bond next to minus M type of group. Suppose if there is a carbonyl group, if you want to introduce a double bond next to this carbonyl, means that is we need, if you want to prepare alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, then this is one method of introducing alpha beta unsaturated double bond. So that is by treatment of active methylene group with base, then followed by reaction with disulfide compound, followed by oxidation and elimination, it is going to lead to the formation of alpha beta unsaturated double bond. So this is a very useful reaction for the preparation of alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound by using organosulfur compound, that is diphenyl or dimethyl disulfide compounds. Next, very important reaction where the organosulfur compounds are used is Umplung synthesis, is an acid catalyzed reaction between aldehyde and thiol, gives dithioacetal derivative, and this is known as Umplung synthesis. So one of the important reaction of organosulfur compound is Umplung synthesis. So this Umplung or polarity inversion is very, very important in organic synthesis. So how we can prepare this Umplung is by acid catalyzed reaction between aldehyde and thiol. So it is going to form dithioacetal derivative, and it is known as Umplung. Means there is reversal of polarity will take place. So before this aldehyde, this carbon is electrophilic. So whenever we are going to do Umplung synthesis, so whatever the Umplung we are going to get by the reaction of aldehyde and thiol, there is reversal of polarity. Means now this carbon no more it is electrophilic, it is now going to act as nucleophilic. So that's why it is called polarity inversion. So, and this Amplanck synthesis is very, very important for preparation of different carbonyl compounds and hydrocarbon derivatives. So this reversal of polarity of carbonyl compounds and also sulfur atom stabilizes the carbon ion, so making possible reaction with electrophile. So at one stage there is reversal of polarity. So why this reversal of polarity is going to take place is because sulfur atom stabilizes whatever the anion it is going to form. So this, now the carbon is going to act as a nucleophile. So there is possibility of reaction with different type of electrophiles. So now if we take Amplanck, if it is treated with base, then it is going to form carbon ion derivative, carbon ion intermediate. This carbon ion intermediate will undergo reaction with different electrophiles to form corresponding products. So now how to remove this dithioacetal group? Since we are looking for the preparation of different carbonyl as well as hydrocarbon derivatives, how this dithiol group will be get removed to get corresponding carbonyl or hydrocarbon is, so dithio derivative hydrolytically cleaved in presence of mercury ion to form corresponding carbonyl derivative, while in presence of rhanion nickel it undergoes reductive desulfurization to form corresponding hydrocarbon derivative. So whatever the dithio derivative we are going to get after a reaction with electrophile, so now we need to remove this group. Now this dithiol group is just acting as a protecting group for the carbonyl group. So after the reaction with electrophile, now if you want carbonyl derivative, then for that one it has to be hydrolytically cleaved by water in presence of mercuric ion. So if the mercuric ion along with water, it will undergo hydrolytic cleavage to form corresponding carbonyl derivative. Suppose we want hydrocarbon derivative, then the method is available, that is the reductive desulfurization reaction. Means if we treat this dithiol derivative with rhanion nickel under hydrogen atmosphere, it is going to give corresponding hydrocarbon derivative, that is through reductive desulfurization reaction. So this is very, very important reaction of organosulfur compound, that is Amplanck synthesis. There will be reversal of polarity, so thereby we can get different kinds of carbonyl as well as hydrocarbon derivative depending upon the deprotection of dithiol group. So next important reaction is Julia olefination. So this Julia olefination is a useful synthetic method to convert aldehydes and ketones to olefin using aryl sulfone. So whatever we have discussed in the oxidation step of thioethers upon treatment with mild oxidation, it is going to form sulfoxide. Sulfoxide upon further reaction with the oxidizing agent, it will give sulfone. So here aryl sulfones are used to get olefin from aldehydes. So how we are going to get, this is the reaction, and this reaction is known as Julia olefination. Means aryl sulfones upon treatment with a base like butyl lithium aldehyde followed by acetic anhydride, it is going to form sulfone derivative. So this sulfone derivatives upon treatment with sodium amalgam in methanol will undergo elimination reaction to give E alkene. So this Julia olefination is an highly stereoselective reaction and it is going to give E alkenes. So if we look at the mechanism, how these aryl sulfones are useful in converting aldehydes or ketone to olefins. So the reaction proceeds with addition of phenyl sulfonyl carbanion to an aldehyde or ketone to form intermediate alcohol, which is esterified in situ by acetic anhydride. Finally, the reductive elimination with sodium amalgam furnishes alkene. So what happens is, first this aryl sulfone will undergo deprotonation reaction to form sulfur elide. So this sulfur elide will undergo addition reaction with aldehyde or ketone to form corresponding alcohol derivative. So this alcohol derivative undergo esterification reaction in presence of acetic anhydride to form acetyl derivative. This acetyl derivative will undergo reductive elimination in presence of sodium amalgam to give corresponding alkene, and this Julia olefination reaction is an stereoselective, means it is going to give E alkene. So how we are going to get E alkene is, so whenever this sulfur halide react with carbonyl group and followed by esterification, it is going to form two diastereomers. Means here the sulfone group and acetal group, they are on the same side, whereas in the other diastereomers they are on the opposite side. So if this diastereomers react with sodium amalgam, so how it is going to react with sodium amalgam is through the formation of free radicals. So single electron transfer will take place and it is going to form a free radical derivative. So this will undergo homolytic cleavage. So there will be loss of this sulfone group intermediate. This free radical intermediate, once again it will take an electron from sodium and it is going to form anion. So this anion will assist in the elimination of acetyl group, and thereby it is going to form alkene. So both the diastereomers will form this same free radical mechanism. Both are involved in the same free radical. Both diastereomers will react in the same fashion. So why it is going to form E-alkene is because it wants the other substitution should be opposite to each other, because it has to be in order to minimize the repulsion. So in order to minimize the repulsion, so both the diastereomers will undergo the same reaction at the stage of formation of carbanion. So this is the stable conformation. So with this conformation, it is going to give stereoselective alkene, that is E-alkene, because this is more stable. So both the diastereomers will react up to this one. It is same. So in this case, the other diastereomers where the two groups are on the same side, and OAC group and carbanion will be in the same phase, then there will be repulsion. To avoid that repulsion, they will undergo CC bond rotation. So that CC bond rotation will lead to this stable arrangement, and finally elimination of acetyl group will lead to the formation of E alkene. So these are the important reactions of organosulfur compound. Thank you.